earlier this morning, we received information that Joshua Okayo had been found in Murang'a County near Maragua River by a good Samaritan who was on his way to work. And while upon finding him, Joshua Okayo seemed to be in a position, in a state that one would describe as a state of confusion. Joshua Okayo went missing on Wednesday afternoon at about 2:30 p.m. He sent distress messages to a couple of his friends indicating that he was in danger. Immediately, moments after sending those messages, his phone went off and efforts to try to locate him were futile. So immediately we got the message that he was missing. As a council, we quickly jumped into action and began looking for him at the nearest police stations in Rongai, where he was last seen.
Which we want to respect his privacy as a patient here, but the way we have seen him, this is not the same person we know. He's not active as he is. So we know and we believe he has gone through a lot. Every Kenyan has a right to demonstrate. They have a right and freedom of expression. And what we have seen in the last few days, citizens were reacting and expressing themselves against the government by way of demonstrating. And what we have seen, the government, in total breach of this constitution, instead of even appreciating that if our colleague and those others have committed criminal offenses, they have a right as arrested persons to be arraigned in court within 24 hours. What we have experienced in the few days is the government trying to take us during the days before we had our constitution, days of extrajudicial killing.
Actually, from what I've heard from him, he looked shaken. And he has told me that he was tortured. He has a lot of pain beginning from the neck and on his entire body, chest, and even the leg and ankles. So that one shows that he was indeed tortured and he was under a difficult situation. Just hope you know what they are feeling. For my dad and all that, they are feeling so pain and they were restless. Until this hour, I've been receiving several calls. People have been calling me to inquire how Joshua is, how we have reached with his condition. And indeed, it has not been easy for us. So as a family, we have been shaken. We have been threatened by this issue. And being that Joshua is a young guy and should not experience this, I can assure you that indeed, the family is not happy about it.
Kitendo ambacho kilitendeka kwa mwanafunzi wetu kilikuwa kimetia shule wasiwasi sana. Na kwa vile tumempata tunashukuru sana. Ile tu ni kuambia serikali kwamba tuna katiba na tukiahidi kwamba sisi tunafuata katiba. Wanafunzi wako na uhuru wa kuandamana, wako na uhuru wa kupeleka petition parliament, na pia wako na uhuru hata kupeleka petition kwa president. Kwa hivyo kuticha wanafunzi, kuwachukua, kuwatupa kwa mto na kuwaumiza ni jambo mbaya sana. Sababu tukiangalia historia yetu, tunajua kwamba miaka ya enzi, wakati wa KANU, utawala wa KANU, wakati wa Tukufu Rais, marehemu Moi, hizi ndio vitendo ambazo zilikuwa zimetendeka.